Come.
Freedom.
I think she's up to something. I reckon Nita's been here and she's trying to cover it up.
She's back on the scene.
I don't know. Of course, Ellie's denying all knowledge.
I don't have postnatal depression. I am just not ready to be a mum. I want to put her up for adoption.
Mrs. Sinclair, your replacement.
Jack, I have made up my mind. I want to give Steph up for adoption.
And you've just seen fit to tell me that now?
I just thought if Perry slept on it, then...
It isn't a phase, Tom. This isn't gonna pass. I want to give Steph up, I'm sorry. I can't do this anymore, Tom. I can't pretend that this is right. And if that makes me a bad person, then...
Celine, wait. Will you slow down? Look, wait.
Look, it is fine if you didn't want to speak to me when you were inside, but you could at least let me know when you got out, Cameron.
But I phoned you when I was inside. Yeah, I know I said I wouldn't, but I cracked, wanted to hear your voice. Then Pete picks up the phone and makes it quite clear you don't want to hear mine. I mean, what is he, your secretary?
Pete said that.
Oh, yeah, didn't he tell you? I knew something was going on. What a creep.
It was you that told me to live my life. And it was you that said you didn't exist anymore.
Celine, you know I didn't mean it like that. You know, when we go and wait, you needed to get on, to move on.
Guess what happened?
How did that go?
How'd you think?
Oh, sorry, mate. Look, a lot can happen in 2 months, but wait till we get us out of that B&B and into a decent bachelor pad. You'll be back on your feet in no time.
What do you want, Lockie?
Well, you left your phone on the boat. Jack called about Perry, and I'm wary about making your bad day worse, but didn't sound good.
Anyway, as I said, you'll still be in charge for as long as you feel able. I'll simply be shadowing you, learning from you, as it were.
Sorry, Patrick, I'm gonna have to go. I'm working at Minicabs today, I did tell you, remember. Actually, I'm running a bit late, so if you need me, just call me, okay?
I'm not a child, Maxine.
I know that. I'm sorry, it's just...
It's fine. I'll see you later.
Okay.
That's your carer?
My wife, actually.
Oh. How domestic. How are you coping with things, out of interest? I understand this is a very difficult time for you.
My work keeps me busy, thank you. Although I have to say, I'd cope a hell of a lot better if someone wasn't stalking me through the corridors.
A necessary step for a streamlined...
Why don't you just come out with him, You're evaluating me, aren't you? Why? Does the governors no longer think I'm up to the job?
There's no need to get paranoid. You must have realised the governors were lining up your replacement. You might not have realised that I would be here so soon. But, as I said, for the time being, I'm here to shadow and to learn. And with that in mind, I noticed that you're covering a maths class this afternoon. Admirable you remain so hands-on in such trying circumstances. I look forward to seeing you work.
Read that to me. What does it say?
Says here, none of your business.
Oh, grow up, Ellie. The only reason I kept this from your dad overnight is to give you a chance to explain yourself. Ellie told me you were over me, but I don't want to let this go so easily. We've been together too long to let a stupid fight come between us.
Yes, I've already cringed my way through that once, thank you, Rachel.
So you do know what it means, then? The Max still had a chance of being back together with her.
What's going on?
A letter from Nita to Mac. I found it in the bin. No address, hand-delivered. Which is why she was acting so weird yesterday.
Nita was hit. Why'd you throw this away?
Dad's better off without that letter and better off without her.
Well, I think we'll let him be the judge of that. Thank you very much. I'll ring him.
She had an affair. Nita had an affair.
What you're saying doesn't mean you're a bad person. But it doesn't mean I understand it. I don't understand how you can say you love Steph and then you want to let her go.
It's because I love her that I have to let her go. She deserves a better life than this, Tom. She deserves parents who are old enough to look after her properly. Who don't have to feed her in between revising for the GCSEs. She deserves normal. And so do we. Don't you want it to go back to how it used to be?
I've never been very good at normal.
Do you remember when it first blew up? When everyone found out that I was pregnant? I told you then that I wasn't ready. And we sat there, and you promised me that whatever happened to this baby, that it wouldn't come between us.
Yeah, well, what's happened since then, Pez?
Well, I still love you. You are still the most important person in the world to me. You still feel the same, right? Tom?
Yeah. Yeah, of course I do.
As soon as I knew what I wanted, I felt good again.
Okay, then.
What?
I'll give Steph up. If that's what you want, we'll give her up.
I love you.
Me too. You know, and whatever happens, do you remember that?
Ellie, you wouldn't lie about this, right?
Are you serious? I mean, it was the Pilates instructor. I caught them together twice.
Damien. Dad let that guy into our house, he'll be gutted.
He deserves to know anyway. He deserves to know that Nita wants to give things another go. Of course she wants to give it another go. Dad was basically her personal cash machine. She's 3 years older than me. Need I explain the appeal of a guy that old to you?
That old guy is your dad.
And that is exactly the reason why I care enough to stand between them. Fine. If I'm the only one, take the letter. You let her get her claws back into him. But first, just do me a favour. You go down there and you look at him and you honestly tell me that he's not doing so much better and that he hasn't turned a corner. I mean, ask yourself, do you really want to ruin that progress?
I'll speak with Dad and see how he's doing.
You know, I always thought Damien was gay.
I guess he just didn't fancy you.
I'm sorry.
What for?
She's your granddaughter and they're just going to take her away.
Pez, it's okay for a teenager to want to be a teenager, you know that? Plus, if this is what my number one girl needs to be happy, then this is what needs to happen. Which is just as well, because my number two girl will not talk to me.
Tom. You'll be all right.
And you're just going to let her walk away like that?
To be fair, I was pretty preoccupied with you. But this is the only place I need to be right now.
Go and sort it out. I'm all right. You know, for the first time in ages, I am all right. I feel like a huge weight has just been lifted. I know I'm doing the right thing.
So do I. So mean you okay then? Pez?
Look, thanks for helping me say how I really feel. But what you did to my mum and dad, I can't forgive you for that.
Just happy to be back in your life.
Well, I guess if we're all sure that's the way we want to go, we better start making plans about how we handle what comes next.
I want to take her for a walk, if that's all right. Just to say goodbye, meet her.
In Patrick's shopping, I see. Never realised he was into celebrity gossip.
The magazine's for me. And yes, the milk is for Patrick.
ran out of unicorn blood, did they?
So I heard you'd moved back in with Nancy?
Platonically.
And what does that mean?
I don't know, but she keeps on saying it, and I think it means I can't sleep with her.
Pity for you. This is really embarrassing, but I've left my purse at work.
It's all right, mate. I've got it. That should cover it, and that is all, please, Mum.
Thank you. It's just the babysitter cancelled, and I've been rushed off my feet with everything.
Max, I know you. It's all right to put yourself first sometimes, OK? Cheers. See you later.
Thank you. Oh, sweetheart.
I'd like to book 2 tickets to London, please. 2 children. Yeah, leaving today.
Be keeping an eye on you while your teacher's away. So, you get your books out and turn to page number...
If I may. I just thought I'd introduce myself. I am Mrs. Sinclair, soon to be your new head teacher. I shall be observing your classes for the next few weeks, where I shall be keeping my eyes open for any bad apples. Should I happen to find any, I shall not hesitate to pluck them from the tree and make crumble of them. You have been warned.
Right, so...
That is, of course, not to say that you should give your outgoing head teacher anything less than absolute respect during the time he has left. I can assure you that anyone making an already vulnerable man's final weeks at this school any more difficult than they have to be will have me to answer to. Thank you.
And Tom's okay with this?
Yes, he recognises that's what Perry wants to do.
And what about what Tom wants to do? Has anyone thought about that?
Guys, I think Tom's gone.
He went with Steph.
No, I mean gone. He's taken his bag and a load of his and Steph's clothes are gone.
Come on, Celine. Look, you know I've been in prison. I can pick a lock.
Oh, yeah, Cam. Because that's the way to a girl's heart, innit? Breaking and entering.
I'm sorry. All right, it's been a stressful day. Perry's given Steph up.
I'm sorry about that.
Well, I didn't come here to get sympathy.
So why did you come here? Because I thought we said everything we needed to say earlier.
Well, I came because I don't want to lose 2 people I love in the same day. If I could at all help it.
You told me to move on.
You know what? I never had my hearing, and they told me I'm a free man. Like, my whole life just laid out again. And all I could think was, I don't want to spend a single second away from you. Away from Perry, away from the people I love the most. So I'm asking you. Celine, I am begging you, take me back.
Where to, mate?
2 months ago. They're gonna take her away, Darren. They're gonna take my daughter away. And I don't know what to do.
You alright, Dad? How's things? What with you?
Anita. There is no me, Anita.
And you're, okay with that, are you?
You know what, son? Yeah, I think I am. I mean, I've got enough going on at this place, haven't I?
You know, if you ever did want to...
Cry?
I was going to go for talk, but whatever. I'll just stick the notebook on, then you can cry your eyes out.
That was the one Christmas I had one too many...
Whiskies.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember. I mean it, though.
Nathan, I'm fine, really. All things considered, Nita was probably too young for me. Too young and too different. You live and learn, eh?
Cheers, then.
It's not too late, you know. It's not too late to let me go. There's a bus coming soon. I can get on it.
You know I can't do that.
Please. No one needs to know. Just let me get to the train station.
And where will you go then, eh? What will you do?
I'll go to London. Stay with OB. I'll get a job.
All right, yeah. And what then? What about your education? What about your future? Now, what if OB doesn't want a teenage boy turning up with a baby daughter? What then?
Look, I'm sorry, okay? I'm sorry there was no master plan. I'm sorry I'm not 30 with a job and a house and the ability to run my own life. I'm sorry if the only thought I had was for my daughter.
Mate, you don't have to be sorry. But running away is not the answer. Not if you want to give her the life you know she deserves.
I just feel so powerless.
No, I wish I could tell you that feeling goes away. Mate, when I was your age, yeah, I couldn't even look after a goldfish. But you're not me. Yeah, you don't hide. And seeing you face up to your responsibilities, I know you're not my lad, but you make me so proud you might as well be. You make us all proud. Every single day.
You still couldn't look after a goldfish.
You're not wrong. Right, come on, let's go, all right? Before Jack finds us and kills us both.
Darren, can we just sit here for a minute?
Yeah. Of course.
Now, your forthcoming exam will be in two parts.
Quiet.
As I was saying, the exam will be in two parts, so you need to plan your time accordingly.
You, out. Be quick about it. Come and see me at the head teacher's office after the final bell. Thank you.
I'm sorry, Mr. Blake. Please do continue.
Mr. Blake.
I heard the first time, thank you.
That's quite enough of that. Thank you very much.
I am in charge of this class.
Ah, hey, neighbour. Fancy a game?
No, thanks.
Not into football?
Not 12 years old.
Just so you know, it's for my brother. He's on a bit of a downer, so I thought I'd cheer him up. Yeah, and I'm starting in the two downstairs bedrooms tomorrow. As far as semi-aquatic bachelor pads go, what do you think?
Believe it or not, my frame of reference is a little thin in that area.
Well, Ellie, just so you know, if this boat's rocking, by all means, do come knocking.
No way. Where'd you pick this up from?
Think of it as a moving-in present.
Thank you, Locke. I'll have a word with Celine, but I'm sure there's somewhere we can fit it.
What?
Hi. She took me back. We're moving in together.
Great.
Go on, then. Bags of the blues.
For what it's worth, I think you made the right decision.
And for what it's worth, I don't. Nita didn't have an affair with Damien. He's gay.
Must have got it wrong.
It doesn't matter anyway. Ellie's right. That seems to have really turned the corner.
What are you lot conspiring about?
Nothing.
Well, in that case, you won't mind getting back to your post, eh, Mr. Barman? And take a little help or two.
You're better off without her, Dad.
Yeah, I know.
Boy, what were you thinking? Cheers, Darren, for bringing him back.
I'm a taxi driver. That's what I do. That's it.
Yeah. You should have told me that you were thinking of running away.
Well, you'd have tried to stop me.
Yeah. Yeah, I would have. But you should have said, because then I would have known.
Not how much I care. Pez, I've told you a million times.
And I would have known what you were prepared to give up. She can stay. You don't have to give her up. Steph, she can stay. But I can't. I'm sorry, Tom, but you're gonna have to make a choice.
You happy now? Get what you wanted, did you?
For the last time, Mr. Blake, I was not sent here to evaluate you. I've said many times I was here to shadow and to learn. But what I've learned is that you aren't up to this job. You're unstable, unhinged. Whether this is down to your illness is unclear. But it's also of no consequence, because I must put the children first. I've told the board about your breakdown.
Breakdown?
Well, what would you call that episode back in the class? Performance art. Now, the board were clear. Well, at least I was clear, and the board compliant. You have been made redundant, effective immediately. I am the new head teacher of this school.
As soon as I saw Steph, I knew that I'd never ever put anyone else before her. And it kills me that you don't feel the same.
You don't love me anymore.
Of course, I love you. Earlier, on the jetty, you said the reason for letting Steph go was because you loved her.
No, that's not the same.
It is. And it's not you who's been selfish, it's me. Because I've seen how unhappy this has made you. But I still... I love you. I just don't want you to be unhappy.
Then don't do this. You said that this wouldn't break us apart. You promised me.
And I believed it. I did. In my head, it was always going to be the three of us. I so wanted it to be the three of us.
It can't be.
Yeah, well, I know that. You gave me a choice. Oh, well, I've made it. I'm sorry, Perry. I'm choosing Steph.
A waitress delivering steak on her chest and another trainee who wants to lick his face. Challenging new recruits for Kitchen Impossible with Michelle Rue Jr. starting tonight at 9. And on E4, Leonard's lips have had a dalliance. Brand new Big Bang at 8:30.
Table for one.
Play with me?
No spinning.